Hey, yeah, this is Louis de Puy and welcome back to another video, which is this time kind of a video where I explain what I actually did in the AlphaCraft video about the house that I built. And I felt like, because of time lapse, that it wasn't fair for you guys because you can't really see what I did exactly. And this time I'm gonna tell you exactly how I came across the design I did in AlphaCraft, step by step, 5 steps in total. And I'll try my very best to tell you, because you know the thing is, I've been building a lot of medieval style buildings and stuff like that, but sometimes it gets a little bit boring to use the same technique, or maybe use the same technique to build unique builds. But this is a total different style, and it was kind of hard to actually come by because I had to try a lot of things. But that's what makes Minecraft fun, I guess, for me at least, is keep practicing and keep changing styles to implement maybe even more blocks, like the granite block that not a lot of people like, and the bricks that I myself don't really like as well. So I try to do something with blocks I don't like. It looks kind of like a old Greek or Mediterranean style. That's what Suzy Nouveau said. I don't know if I pronounced it right, but she said it looks like it. I had no idea while building it, but she said it looks kinda like it, so I'm gonna stick up to that. If you have a better suggestion about the name of this style of building, because I've searched it up and it looks like a building that would stand in a hot climate, maybe not too hot. I mean, not like desert hot, but maybe it could actually fit in the desert, I don't know. But at least I'm gonna show you what I did exactly. So step one, starting with step one, is all about trying to find the details, and that's what I did, because obviously you don't have to follow these steps, but that's how I got this new style. Because if you need a new style, obviously you're gonna need to find a new style. So literally try to get those round shapes, try to add a little bit of depth, the uses of blocks, like as you can see, acacia wood, and then we have jungle wood, and we have polished granite, just normal granites, some bricks like that, trapdoors, because those you can see through, and those trapdoors you can see through. So there's a difference between those trapdoors. That's why I used the spruce one as like a shelter for the rain or anything like that, or the sun, you know. And I used some I forgot the gates. I forgot what those were called, but oh well. And use those stairs, those walls. It's going good. To add a little bit of support to those fences. And what the difference is between the gates and this is that those fences have like a little point sticking out, and those don't. So it looks a little bit less thick than those. So, but you can play around with the design, as you can see. And if you want to play even more, you know, you can just add like walls like that or something like that, and it will add like that round shape at the bottom. But yeah, I think it looks better like this, supported enough. Otherwise it would be just too much bricks, in my opinion. And we have even like the lantern and a thing, and then the trapdoor on top of it. It looks like it's holding the wall together and the lantern, and looks really good because it adds a little bit of color. And obviously, like a too thick wall, to not being able to, to add a little bit more detail, like round shape, as you can see, brick, and you know, brick. So it adds like that little transition between colors, which I really like. And this thing is not to get through even when you're crouching. So as you can see, I can get through even if I open them. It's like even better protected. And then we have the flower pot with a flower inside of it. Obviously, it should just have a little bit of color, which is something that is really needed for this build, because the color is really bland, boring in my opinion. So we have to work around and try to find something out to be able to make it look good. And here a banner, just a brown banner with a trapdoor. I'm not sure if the villagers could walk through, but it's to be able to put down the banner. Maybe some strings, I don't know, but that will work. And then we have this, just to get a little transition between the spruce trapdoors and the granite. As you can see, those colors are just like in a flat manner transitioning to each other. But while adding this, which is less big than a slab, if you put down a slab, for example, it will be really flat above. But if you put down a trapdoor like this, then you have the transition between those two stairs. and this, yes man, and oh, this weather. I should add like a comment block or something like that. But like, I even use this for this part right here, and as you can see, there's even more designs. Like, I added a little window with some fences, because I felt like if it's gonna be ancient, they're not gonna use glass, right? And then on this part, like another design, you could even like add a little wall right here to add a bit more detail, as you can see. But then you should just remove like another color or something like that. I don't know, but it works well. But now let's move on to step two, because I don't want to talk a bit too much. Step two is finding the shape and the height. Yes, of course, that's the thing we need to do for every single building, because this is what's gonna make this building stand out, in my opinion, is the shape, like the depth. As you can see, wall, one in mind, wall, one in mind, wall, and then we have this layer is higher than this layer, and then this layer is higher than this layer, so we can add those cheeky little pathways to go through the building and actually have different views, which is something I really want to implement in the builds while you build this, is building, terraforming the things around so that you can look around and be like, oh, it's looking beautiful. And then all above, we have even a little lookout tower for even more view on all the sides, which is really great. And as you can see, I tweaked a bit the details. By the way, I had like first the sides for the bricks and then fill this in with that, but I will change that later, I will show you. But like, I added those stairs instead of full blocks, and the reason is because this way you can actually see through here, there's a little gap there, and that's only, nah, it's not only with this one, but I really like the jungle trapdoors, which I changed from the acacia one, because you can see that little detail, minor detail, it really adds like a little bit of shape to the building as well. As you can see, it's a lot bigger difference than what we did right here, and look at this now. In my opinion, way better. And one thing is, I built a tower in the middle, right? So normally if I would remove this wall, it will connect to this one, and it will be just like one flat wall to another flat wall on another level. So one thing to make the transition better is by actually adding another wall. That's it. You just add another wall and then it just doesn't have that weird transition, and I did it on every side. You don't have necessarily to have to do that, but it's just to show you off what I did. Moving to step three, there we go. This one is really big, so I actually built every time like another design to show you all the possibilities, and you can go with big, big skills with this. You can even build one right here, even higher, so you have that really different level feeling, you know, really great. But step three, which is once you're done with actually the shape, that's what I did. Once again, don't have to do this, but that's how I did it for this build, is adding the windows. So just move around, search for blank areas like this. You can even add little windows like this, really hidden. You can even add some colors behind if you would like to. I mean, just to show you, I mean, because we're, it's not a diamond or anything, so I can take my time, I guess. But look at this, you can just add like a little color there and you just add something different. But we're not gonna do this for this, we're now just showing you all the possibilities you can do and use while building. And then once the windows are done, like little windows, less little windows, and bigger windows like this one, as you can see, just adding like a little bit of shape right here, details, as you can see, really good. If you have like high towers and stuff, you can just do this stuff and even add like, I don't know, slabs, and then add flower pots or trapdoors and put a flower pot there, or just hanging leaves. You can do everything you want. But once that is done, I even added like the roof parts, and let me set time to zero because otherwise you wouldn't be able to see. You can even like add like those carpet things. I don't really like the red because it's a little bit too red and not ancient looking. So I would use colors that are less bright, I guess, but like blue. I like blue, but red is kind of But how you do that is just putting strings down. You won't even be able to see them if you just walk straight like this, maybe a bit. But if you don't pay attention, it doesn't really matter. Yeah, as long as it's tree high, I guess, because I'm not sure if villagers now. I don't think they can't do that. They can't. Don't get. You can make traps out of it. So I don't think they count this as a block. But as you can see, guys, the rain is killing me. As you can see, I didn't use really square shapes right here. I went in a little diagonal way right there. Once again, one three parts sticking out, going back in it again, and right here, just straight, straight. And in here, this corner is not filled at all. So this way you have all those different shapes and depth, which really adds a lot of detail to the building. And the funny things about building those type of buildings that you can walk around on the traps, on the stairs, talk Dutch right there. You can just go around all the way to the top, and if you want to go to the tower, you can even add like a little ladder right here, and being able to do to be there. And then you have plenty of room, as you can see right here, even on this part, which is looking really good. And then one thing you can add as well, while we being here, you can, to make it look like it's a little bit weathered or more crumbly like this, you can add those little bricks and stairs and walls and slats, play around with the colors and stuff like that, remove walls and put down some stairs. And then once that is done, you can even take some leaves, let's say just oak leaves like this, to make it look like it has been overgrown like that, you know. And then you take some bone meal. It's actually something I would tell you for the next step. But like, look at this. I mean, it's not the best yet, but I mean, you get the idea, right? You can add like a couple flowers, adding a flower right here. I mean, I haven't really paid attention to what I did here. Maybe I would bring this one more up right there, just to not make it completely flat like that. It's been overgrown, maybe adding some vines, but see what it does with this little bit of detail, what you can do with a building. Didn't do the back, but as you can see, not done anything really. And even like a really little balcony right here, look at this, it looks amazing. But as you can see, it's not looking good at all if you don't do anything to it. And then going back to the front, just adding some windows and just those roofs. There's so much. And now let's move on to the final two steps, which is the final build I actually used, not built a complete replica of this, used some aspects, but once again, I don't want to use the same building over and over again, because you need to keep yourself entertained by doing different things. But level 4 is detailing the house itself. So as you can see, I actually added another block, which is the jungle wood block, which fitted really well with the colors right there, and a bit like the bricks and stuff, but looks like a bit more weathered and used. And just this adds way more color to the building. So I'm going step by step what kind of details I used. But once that is all done with the windows and stuff, you just have to have to walk around and try things out and see what details work. As you can see, just like a little flower in a little corner here, which is a really small detail which I really like. Just those small things, you know. And then blue next to red. The roses work really well with this color. I never really liked roses, but now that it has been changed, like the design of the what is it? Nah, the design of the flower has been changed. I really like it. And then those lanterns, putting them a bit, like I said, the vegetation a bit around to the place where it's not used. Those stairs, just to complete the building. Then some flower pot, as you can see, just one fence here, just to make it look like, you know, extra detail. Didn't really finish it all the way down. You can add those little differences. You can even finish it all by putting down one more fence like this, but I really like this one a bit more. So it's all about tweaking and stuff like that. But using those things to keep things dry from the sun and stuff, you can put barrels, things that you don't want to get wet in beneath it, so it adds a little bit of story, as you can see. Adding those buttons add a little bit of color that are not too big of a deal, as you can see, it's just really small. So if you don't overuse it, it will be good. Putting down lanterns everywhere, really something I like. Like I said, the blue one right here, really nice. Add a chest, some flower pots, looks like drink cups, or maybe people want to plant things. I don't know, barrels of course for storage area. As you can see, a looming thing just to add a bit of different blocks. And what I added even more are those trapdoors. Actually, change those to spruce later on. Can even use jungle wood would be better, I guess. I'm still hesitating if it would use jungle wood or spruce, but they both work. But I think lighter colors work better for hot climate because bright doesn't hold warmth and a lot, and dark does that. So yeah, and then just like a little roof right here to keep us dry from the rain. Oh, the rain actually goes through the carpet. Didn't know. Good thing to learn. I even learned in my own tutorials while I try to learn new things, guys. How amazing is that? As you can see, just this one didn't really do anything but put down a trapdoor in beneath it. And this one actually used some signs to make that feeling that it's holding a bit more. I think it's jungle signs. Yeah, it is. Used jungle leaves because that was at the brightest. But I think that I would prefer, now looking back at those, to use some oak leaves, because the oak leaves are less jungly, I guess. And maybe use those as like the palm leaves, you know? Because now we have a difference. Those are the bushes, and those are the palm leaves. Don't really see a big difference, but I mean, if you're really picky, you could see that. So in behind like a little back door going out, because otherwise if there's a mob coming out, like a really small one, it works as well, then you have to run out. And I even tried like a really round shape, it could work. I mean, that's a bit of detail as well, but in my opinion I would prefer to actually stick to the more straight lines and maybe breaking them a bit with the stairs. And as you can see, you use the wall technique to actually add that little curve right there. Really great. So, and then step 5, which I actually already told you, is once the building is done, you actually have to build around this building to make it fit the nature. Because if it's standing on its own, it looks like those are two separate things, right? But if you add like the little bit of grass, paths, maybe I use like the jungle planks, coarse dirt, and the best pathways just to mark the path, a bit of grass. Maybe you can even add some putzel, because putzel looks less green than the grass, but then will remove a lot of colors, I don't know. But adding those vegetations, flowers, stuff like that, maybe even adding, I'm just like trying things out now, I'm not really sure, because here there's nothing, right? It's really bland. But you could even like add, I don't know, like a little rock formation right here, make it really interesting looking, then taking some slabs, just like, I'm just showing you a really basic design that you could use. You can do something, you know, like this, and maybe like this, then add a bit of ground like this, and then maybe one more here, ground, you do this, you fit it all up a bit like this. It looks like a little, you know, cliff-sidey thing. Like this, you know, boom. But really, really works out. Adds a little bit of detail. You can even like put one more here, I don't know. But I really want to get this right actually. Like this, and then we have a stair that's actually holding this one, bit of detail right here. So really, really simple design. I don't know, you can even do this, so that you have like that really, but I don't really that distant decision. So it's always trying things out, different styles like this, and eventually you'll get something right. And then take the bone meal just to finish this up. And what I would do is maybe just add one more right here, you see, and then maybe not the long grass, if it doesn't keep swelling like it. You can add a little bit of flowers, and as you can see, it's already like stuck to the wall a bit. Really like, it looks like a really small cliff, but it really makes it look like the building's actually implemented into the world, into the nature. And that's what, in my opinion, really makes the building stand out. There's little details like this, just like a little walkway, and then just imagine I'm just building a way while I try to explain you things. But you can even like add a little pathway right here, you know, and then you have to walk past by, and you're like, oh, that looks really good, you know. And maybe you could even like add a little lantern right here to make the detail a bit more, and then maybe a sign, and then just putting down nice note. Just thinking about this right away. So while you keep building your building, just keep thinking about what would fit to the building. And as you can see, just like implementing those nature things really, really makes the building stand out. And while you actually look through the things, you wouldn't like to look at this building. But while you stand here, you kind of like, oh, this looks like actually pretty good there. I want to be there, you know, and then maybe a palm tree there, some more palm trees there, maybe some marketplaces right there. And then you have like a full building with a bit of details around, and it looks way better than it was standing on its own. So that's it, guys. I hope I didn't actually talk for too long, because I tend to talk for a long time while I do those things. That's the reason why I made two separate videos from the time lapse and me explaining the things like that, because I want you guys to be able to actually use the same style if you like. So yeah, and once again, I forgot to say that, but this is a straight line, just breaking two blocks, adding stairs to make them more shape right in, and in a little corner really adds a lot of aesthetics to the building. So yeah, thank you for watching, guys, and if you've been all the way through here, thank you, because that means a lot for me if you keep watching my videos and actually leave comments and likes, because that's the reason I keep uploading them, because I see people that are actually supporting me and I really like that. So I want to thank you for that. Made this video beforehand because I'm going to a festival for 3 days, so I can't really make something. So the next video will be probably up on Sunday. If not, then it will be on Monday, then back again, 2 videos every week. So keep that notification bell on and subscribe to the channel if you really want to see more of those stuff. And look at this, looking really good. So thank you for watching once again, and until the next time, can't speak, time guys, time. Goodbye.